meeting is necessary for the council to continue operations of the city.
And discharge
of its lawful purposes, duties, and responsibilities. And is being held pursuant to and in compliance with City of Norfolk Ordinance 48161 as authorized by Virginia Code Section 15.2-1413 and will be conducted telephonically and electronically. Notice of this meeting was given to the public on November 20th, 2020 in the Virginian Palette. An electronic copy of the agenda was posted on the city's website on November 20, 2020. Please stand for a moment of silence and remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag, United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk, please call the roll.
Certainly. Mrs. Doyle?
Here.
Mrs. Graves?
Here.
Mrs. Johnson?
Here.
Mrs. McClellan?
Here.
Mr. Riddick?
Here.
Mr. Smeagol?
Here.
Mr. Thomas?
Here.
Dr. Alexander?
Here. The motion is to dispense with the reading of the minutes of our previous meeting.
Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. Tonight we have three invitations to bid. We will then take up public hearings, then move to the regular agenda items. There is no new business tonight. To address the council on an agenda item, you should have registered to speak prior to 3 p.m. with the clerk. Mr. Clerk, IB1.
Sir, just before that, I'd like to read the resolution for the closed meeting, if you don't mind. Thank you, sir. The resolution certifying a closed meeting of the Council of the City of Norfolk in accordance with the provisions of the Virginia Freedom of Information Act. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
I'd be one, sir.
I'd be one.
The next item is the receipt of bids pursuant to invitation to bid and notice of public hearing scheduled this day pursuant to state law. Notice having been inserted in the local press by the city clerk to accept bids for a long-term garage parking agreement with a term of 10 years for a lease of up to 40 parking spaces in the Fountain Park garage, subject to certain terms and conditions.
Thank you. How many bids have been received?
Only one, sir.
Please read that bid and mark that bid for identification.
This is from City Walk 3 LLC. The undersigned City Walk 3 LLC hereby submits its bid to enter into a garage parking agreement upon the terms and conditions set forth in the ordinance and attached heretofore it as Exhibit A, pursuant to which it will lease up to 40 spaces in the Fountain Park garage located at 130 Bank Street for a term of 10 years at a rental rate equal to the greater of 1, the amount which is 60% of the then current rate for 24/7 unreserved non-residential office parking in the garage under Norfolk City Code, or 2, the then current rate for the residential parking in the garage under Norfolk City Code. And I will mark this as City Walk 3, sir.
Thank you. Are there any additional bids offered? If there are no additional bids offered, I declare the bidding closed. Is there a recommendation from the city staff regarding the bid received from City Walk 3 LLC?
Yes, Mayor and Council, city staff recommends that the bid by City Walk 3 LLC be reviewed by city staff and a recommendation be made to the council along with the public hearing at the December 8, 2020 council meeting.
Is there a motion to continue this matter until the next meeting of the Norfolk City Council on December 8, 2020 to receive the recommendation of the city staff and to consider the bid from City Walk 3 LLC?
I so move.
I second it.
Moved and properly seconded. Is there any further discussion? If not, clerk, please call the roll.
Certainly. The motion is to continue to December the 8th, 2020. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smiegel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. Mr. Clerk, IB2.
IB2 is receipt of bids pursuant to invitation to bid and notice of public hearing scheduled this day pursuant to state law. Public notice having been inserted in the local press by the city clerk to accept bids for a long-term parking garage agreement with a term of 10 years for the lease of up to 27 parking spaces in the York Street garage subject to certain terms and conditions.
Mr. Clerk, how many bids have been received?
One, sir.
Please read that bid and mark that bid for identification.
Thank you. The undersigned WBG Financial Investment and Capital Tenant LLC hereby submits its bid to enter into a garage parking agreement upon the terms and conditions set forth in the ordinance and attached hereto as Exhibit A, pursuant to which it will lease up to 27 spaces in the York Street garage located at 215 West York Street for a term of 10 years at a rental rate equal to the greater of 1, the amount which is 60% of the then current rate for 24/7 unreserved non-residential office parking in the garage under Norfolk City Code, or 2, the then current rate for residential parking in the garage under Norfolk City Code.
Thank you. Are there any additional bids offered?
Yes.
If there are no additional bids offered, I declare the bidding closed. Is there a recommendation from the city staff regarding the bid received from WBG Financial Investment and Capital Tenant LLC?
Mayor and Council, city staff recommends that the bid by WBG Financial Investment and Capital Tenant LLC be reviewed by city staff and a recommendation be made to the council along with the public hearing at the December 8, 2020 council meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Manager. Is there a motion to continue this matter until the next meeting of the Norfolk City Council on December 8, 2020 to receive the recommendation of the city staff and to consider the bid from WBG Financial Investment and Capital Tenant LLC?
I move that we continue.
I second.
It's been moved and properly seconded. Is there any further discussion? If not, Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Certainly, sir. I will mark this bid as WBG Financial Investment and Capital Tenant LLC, 11-24-2020. The motion is to continue to December the 8th. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smiegel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. Mr. Clerk, IB3.
Certainly, sir. The next item is the receipt of bids pursuant to the invitation to bid and notice of public hearing scheduled this day pursuant to state law. Public notice having been inserted in the local press by the city clerk to accept bids for a long-term parking agreement with a term of 10 years for the lease of up to 49 spaces in the Freemason Street garage subject to certain terms and conditions.
Mr. Clerk, how many bids have been received?
One, sir.
Please read that bid and mark that bid for identification.
The undersigned 415 Granby LLC hereby submits its bid to enter into a garage parking agreement upon the terms and conditions set forth in the ordinance and attached hereto as Exhibit A, pursuant to which it will lease up to 56 spaces in the Freemason Street garage located at 161 Freemason Street for a term of 10 years at a rental rate equal to the greater of 1, the amount of which is 60% of then current rate for 24/7 unreserved non-residential office parking in the garage under the Norfolk City Code, or 2, the then current rate for the residential parking in the garage under the Norfolk City Code. And I will mark this 415 Granby LLC.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Are there any additional bids offered? If there are no additional bids offered, I declare the bidding closed. Is there a recommendation from the city staff regarding the bid received from 415 Granby LLC?
Mayor and Council, city staff recommends that the bid by 415 Granby LLC be reviewed by city staff and a recommendation be made to council along with the public hearing at the December 8, 2020 council meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Manager. Is there a motion to continue this matter until the next meeting of the Norfolk City Council on December 8, 2020 to receive the recommendation of city staff and to consider the bid from 415 Granby LLC?
I move that we continue.
I'll second it.
Is there further discussion? If not, Mr. Clerk, call the roll.
Motion is continued to December the 8th, 2020. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Thank you. Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson? Thank you. Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mrs. Meagle?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye.
Mr. Clark, PH1.
Public hearing on the agenda this day pursuant to state law.
Excuse me, Mr. Mayor?
Yes, Ms. McClellan.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes.
Are you guys having a hard time or lagging?
It could be us on our end.
I think there's something going on at City Hall. Your internet's not keeping up to snuff.
All right. Let us check.
You're on.
Jim?
Mr. Mayor, you're on delay.
I'm on delay.
You're on delay.
Okay. Ken, is there something you can do?
No, sir.
Okay. So we just have to wait, Alan. Okay.
I know what you can do. You can switch to Zoom.
I was thinking the very same thing, Tommy. Zoom is what we could do.
Are we ready for public hearing one?
So let's adjourn and sign on to Zoom.
Are we ready for public hearing
one?
Public hearing one scheduled this day pursuant to state law to hear comments on amendments to the Norfolk City Charter in sections 44, 61, 64, and 133 for consideration at the forthcoming session of the General Assembly.
Okay.
I have a resolution expressing the support of the City Council for four amendments to the Norfolk Charter so as to revise or repeal its section 44, 61, 64, and 133 regarding removing references to a poll tax, repealing the Home Guard section, granting certain employment rights to the Deputy Chief of Police, and authorizing the clerk to administer the oath. Adopt the resolution. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Thank you. Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. PH2?
Public hearing two scheduled this day pursuant to state law on the application of the City Planning Commission for a general plan amendment to Appendix C within Plan Norfolk 2030 to repeal a plan for downtown Norfolk 2020 and adopt a vision for the next decade, Norfolk 2030. And the Planning Commission recommends approval by 6-0. An ordinance to amend the city's general plan, Plan Norfolk 2030, so as to replace a plan for downtown Norfolk 2020 with an updated plan entitled A Vision for the Next Decade, Downtown Norfolk 2030. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
I'm very excited about this plan. I want to thank everybody who had a role in making this happen. I vote aye very excitedly.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Yeah, thank you to the Planning Commission. Thank you to planning staff and WPA. I vote aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Yes, also let me add my thanks to the planning staff, Dr. Filer and his team, as well as Ray Gendris and WPA Mill Price, and also the committee that was assembled of citizens that helped bring forth the plan. So thank you all. I vote aye.
Thank you, sir.
PH3.
Public hearing three scheduled this day pursuant to state law on the application of Ross Vieira for a change of zoning from multifamily neighborhood scale to community commercial on property located at 708 East 26th Street. And by 6-0 vote, Planning Commission recommends that this be approved, and the applicant is on the phone if there are questions.
Sure, call roll.
Thank you. I have an ordinance to rezone property located at 708 East 26th Street from multifamily neighborhood scale district to community commercial district. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
This is really a cool thing. Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Thank you so very much. Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smiegel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. Mr. Clerk, R1.
What, PH4?
PH4, I'm sorry.
They go together, actually, so we'll take this first. Public hearing for scheduled this day pursuant to state law on the application of John Rizzo for a change of zoning from multifamily neighborhood scale to community commercial on property located at 930 Ridgate Avenue. The Planning Commission recommends by 6-0 vote to move forward with this, and the applicant is on the phone if needed.
Okay. All right, we're ready to vote.
An ordinance to rezone property at 930 Ridgate Avenue from multifamily neighborhood scale district to community commercial district. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
I vote aye, but I will say that, Mr. Rizzo, I really hope that you are going to do what you indicated early on in your application, and that is that you wanted to use this facility to help those families that have patients, families, and friends that are visiting the medical campus nearby. So I very much hope that that is the intended use, and that's what we see coming forward. Thank you. I vote aye.
Thank you. Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
This is about the second or third time that this property has been rezoned. And I think the last time
thank you, sir. Mr. Smiegel?
I noticed that it had a 2-year cap on it, so that's good, you know, for us to monitor and see how that works. So, aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. Now, R1.
R1 is an ordinance granting a conditional use permit to authorize a short-term rental, vacation rental, on property located at 930 Ridgate Avenue, and the Planning Commission recommends approval by 6-0, and Mr. Rizzo would like to speak on this item, sir.
All right, Mr. Rizzo. Mr. Rizzo, welcome to the Norfolk City Council meeting. You are speaking on R1.
Is he muted?
No, I just unmuted. Can you hear me?
Yes. You're welcome to the council.
We can't.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes.
Okay. It's very broken out. So 930 Ridgate Avenue, we are excited about it. We appreciate the comments from Councilwoman Doyle. That is our intent. We just discovered a need there, 5,000 out-of-state patients each year, and to create something that for families, for visiting faculty, staff, support staff, vendors of the hospital district, and within walking distance. We're excited about the project, and that's all I have to say about it. I've kind of kept everyone in the loop from City Council on. Questions for me?
Certainly. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
I vote aye, but again, Mr. Rizzo, thank you for your comments, and I do hope that your use is intended as you described, because I'm aware of some of the neighbors' concerns. And I actually live right around the corner, so I look forward to seeing your progress. I vote aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Mr. Rizzo, you better watch out. Councilwoman Dole will be paying attention. I vote aye.
Thank you. Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
No.
Thank you. Mr. Smiegel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. R2.
R2 is an ordinance granting a condition.
Mayor?
Yes.
Can y'all do something with the speaker phone doohickey that Mr. Riddick is coming across on? It is very difficult to hear him. And if he has comments on anything, it's really hard to hear what he has to say.
Yeah.
Increase the volume or something.
If we were on Zoom, you could just call in on a phone number.
Wait. R2 is an ordinance granting a conditional use permit to authorize a short-term rental unit vacation rental on property located at 358 West Freemason Street, and Planning Commission recommends approval by 6-0 vote.
Okay.
Dispense with the charter requirement for read the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
No.
Thank you. Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. R3?
R3 is an ordinance granting a conditional use permit to authorize a short-term rental, vacation rental, dwelling unit on property located at 1519 Longwood Drive, and the Planning Commission recommends by a vote of 6-0 to approve. And I will note this was considered generally, continued generally by council at their February 25th meeting. Certainly. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. R4?
R4 is an ordinance authorizing the purchase of up to 50 hours of annual leave accumulated above the current maximum set out in the city code as of December 30th by city or constitutional officers and employees. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
I vote aye, and I want to just thank Chip and his team for putting this into place and making sure that we were looking out for our city employees with the unintended consequences of COVID. So thank you.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Also, thank you, Dr. Feil, and your team, but also thank I want to thank Chef Barron, who's been an advocate for this change for quite some time. And thank you, Dr. Feil, for bringing it to the council. R5.
Is that a yes, sir?
Yes,
aye. R5 is an ordinance approving a right of entry permitting Carolina Marine Structures, Inc. to go upon and use city-owned property located at 700 West Bramilton Avenue for an equipment laydown area. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Yeah, can you identify
what type of equipment?
Does it have to do with the Ohio Creek project, Earl?
No, sir, I don't believe so.
Okay, all right. Okay, well, I'm going
to. Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. R6.
R6 is an ordinance accepting with appreciation gifts in kind and financial contributions to the city from the Friends of the Elizabeth River Trail Foundation and authorizing the city manager to enter into appropriate deeds of gift. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick? Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. R7?
R7 is an ordinance amending the FY 2021 Annual Appropriations Ordinance number 47999 so as to accept, appropriate, and authorize the expenditure of grant funds up to the sum of $16,153 from the Virginia Department of Emergency Management through its State Homeland Security Grant for the Norfolk Community Emergency Response Team Program. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander.
Aye. R8.
R8 is an ordinance approving a First Amendment to lease agreement between the City of Norfolk as lessor and Hornblower Cruises and Events LLC, formerly known as Spirit Cruises LLC, as lessee, and authorizing the city manager to execute the First Amendment to lease agreement on behalf of the City of Norfolk. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smigel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. R9.
R9 is an ordinance approving a First Amendment to lease agreement between the City of Norfolk as lessor and Hornblower Cruises and Events LLC, formerly known as Spirit Cruises LLC, as lessee, for the lessee's use of a portion of the city's waterfront area for docking and berthing its vessel, Virginia Elite, and authorizing the city manager to execute the First Amendment to lease agreement on behalf of the City of Norfolk. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick? Mr. Smigel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye.
R10 is an ordinance approving a First Amendment to lease agreement between the City of Norfolk as lessor and Sidney Mears as lessee for property located at 210 East Main Street in the City of Norfolk, Virginia, and authorizing the city manager to execute the First Amendment to lease agreement on behalf of the City of Norfolk. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Thank you. Mr. Smigel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Thank you. Dr. Alexander?
Aye. R11.
R11 is an ordinance accepting the conveyance of temporary and permanent utility easements by Colony Point Apartments, LLC, over the property located at 901 Arnfield Circle, and authorizing the city manager to accept the deed of easement on behalf of the city. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick? Mr. Smigel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. R12?
R12 is a resolution reaffirming the process of the development of a plan to revitalize the St. Paul's area and establishing a standard for the future mixed-income community and a guaranteed right to return. Adopt the resolution. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
So I want to again take the opportunity to thank, at this point, Susan Perry and her staff and all of the members of the St. Paul's Advisory Committee, as well as Bernard and his team for working with us on the legal aspect of this. This is very important because it goes to the heart of what we've been working on the people first side, is bricks and mortar's fine, but making sure that the people who are affected by this move are taken care of, and making sure that everyone who has a desire to return to the new community will be able to return to the new community. So thank you again to my colleagues on council for always supporting the St. Paul's project and the changes that we've gone through and where we're headed. And I vote aye.
Thank you. Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
No.
Thank you. Mr. Smigel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Let me also thank you, Mrs. Graves, for your leadership in the St. Paul's community. And thank you, Mr. Pishko and Dr. Feiler, for reaffirming our commitment to the residents who want to return, that they will have a right to return to the St. Paul's area. And so that includes, you know, everything that we have identified for redevelopment, revitalization in the entire St. Paul's area, that these families can have a right to return. So, Ms. Graves, thank you for your leadership, and I vote aye.
Thank you, sir.
R13.
R13 is an ordinance authorizing the city manager to amend the purchase and sale agreement for the purchase of certain property known as 731 Sedgwick Street in the city of Norfolk for the Ohio Creek Watershed Improvement Project so as to increase the purchase price from $175,000 to $182,000 and authorizing the expenditure of a sum of $7,000 for that purpose. Dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick? Mr. Riddick?
The mayor.
Yes, Ms. Johnson.
Do we have Mr. Riddick back?
I think Adisa.
He said he was back.
He's back. Mr. Riddick?
I just talked to him. He said he was back.
Here, he would just do this. Here we go.
Okay,
all right, sir, we're going to leave you on this phone.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Now they're frozen.
Okay.
Y'all were frozen too.
Mr. Riddick, is that we're on R13, and that was to amend the purchase of the property at 731 Sedgwick Street for the Ohio Creek Watershed Project, and it's to increase it by 7,000. Is that yes? Thank you, sir. Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Ms. Dr. Alexander?
Aye.
R14 is a resolution certifying the Pamunkey Indian Tribe as the preferred casino gaming operator pursuant to Section 58.1-4109 of the Code of Virginia. Adopt the resolution. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye. R15.
R15 is a letter from the General Registrar and an abstract of votes cast in the city of Norfolk at the general election held on November 3rd, 2020, pursuant to Section 24.2-675 of the Code of Virginia. Receive and file, Mrs. Doyle.
I want to thank Stephanie Isles for and her team for all the great work on Election Day and leading up to it. And I want to thank all the volunteers that staffed all of the precincts, all of the satellite offices, the downtown City Hall. Really, it was a very smooth election, and I'm just very thankful. So I vote aye.
Thank you. Mrs. Doyle, Mrs. Graves?
I agree with Courtney on that. Thank you to Stephanie and her team and all the volunteers. This is a great, it really was a great election. It was very smooth, and especially for it being our first election season with early voting. So thank you to everybody involved. I vote aye.
Thank you. Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Great job, Stephanie and crew. I'm glad this is over. I vote aye.
Mr. Riddick? Thank you, sir. Mr. Smeagol?
Ditto to what everybody else said. Aye.
Thank you. Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Also, let me thank all of you who decided to open more satellite locations in the city of Norfolk. So thank you, members of the City Council. We had four satellite locations, and they were amazing. They were strategically planted throughout the, you know, the community. Mr. Smigel wanted more, but we did get four. Stephanie is our registrar. You did an awesome job. To the electoral board members, thank you for your participation. First time we had, you know, no excuse, you know, absentee voting, early voting, and satellite locations, and this is probably a new trend, a new model. But thank you all. It was fantastic. You didn't have any major problems with people wanting to vote in the city of Norfolk. So I vote aye.
Thank you, sir.
R16.
R16 is an ordinance amending ordinance number 48190, granting an exception from real property taxes by designation to Kojic Memorial Home for the Elderly, Inc., for property located at 2412 East Virginia Beach Boulevard, in order to include the corporate entity that may be a title owner of the property during the term of the exemption. And Mr. Mastracco is available if there are any questions. Thank you, sir. I dispense with the charter requirement for reading the ordinance twice and adopt with the effective date. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smigel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Certainly,
sir. I have a resolution appointing and reappointing 11 members to 4 boards and 2 commissions for a certain term. Adopt the resolution. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smigel? Mr. Smigel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye.
And did you want to amend this one resolution?
Yes.
Okay. And I have one additional add-on, sir. It's a resolution amending the Mayor's Commission on Social Equity and Economic Opportunity, and to add Mrs. Angela Williams Graves, and keeping the number to 12 persons. And then you can act as an ex officio if you like, and she could be a co-chair with Mrs. McClellan.
That's correct.
Okay. Adopt the resolution. Mrs. Doyle?
Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Thank you. Mrs. McClellan?
Angela, I'm looking forward to working with you. Aye.
Thank you. Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smigel?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Aye.
Thank you. And
R17. R17.
The first public hearing scheduled this day pursuant to state law to hear comments on whether to adopt an ordinance drafted by the Committee of Petitioners for the Norfolk Second Amendment Preservation Coalition, proposing to prohibit the City of Norfolk from exercising any authority granted to it to regulate or prohibit the purchase, possession, transfer, ownership, carrying, storage, or transporting of firearms, ammunition, or components, or a combination thereof, and furthermore, to waive the city's sovereign immunity as it relates to any injuries sustained by persons lawfully present on any property owned by the city that it designates as a firearm-free zone.
Thank you. All right, the first speaker we have is Mr. Andrew Denmore.
Is that
on? Okay, we'll come back to Mr. Denmore. What about Mr. Ken Reed? Mr. Reed is not with us. Okay. What about Ms. Elizabeth Corrin?
She is.
Okay, Ms. Elizabeth Corrin.
I am here.
Hello.
Can you all hear me?
Yes, welcome to the meeting. Please state your name and your address. You have 3
Elizabeth minutes. Curran, 78 Gosling Circle, 202 Fishersville, Virginia, 22939.
All right, thank you. You have 3 minutes.
Call me because I wanted to support the rights of the gun owners to because it's given by God in the Constitution of Virginia, I don't want any changes to be made on limiting the ability for anyone to purchase firearms or to protect themselves, especially with things going on in the country that are a little crazy. We all need to be able to protect ourselves, and so I wanted you to support the ability to people to purchase firearms and protect themselves or go hunting, whatever, and use them in a legal manner.
Okay.
That's what I wanted to say. Thank you for listening.
And thank you for participating. Josiah Hunter.
No,
sir. Josiah Hunter is not with us. Mr. Robert Brown. Mr. Brown?
Yes, I'm here, Mayor.
Welcome.
Hey, good evening.
Good evening.
I'm Robert Brown. I'm chairman of the Republican Party of Norfolk and the founder of the Norfolk Second Amendment Preservation Coalition. And I want to thank everybody who joined us tonight for participating. The Constitution of our country was the blueprint of our great nation. Our founding fathers believed that a right to keep and bear arms was fundamental to our very freedom as a people. I believe the Constitution is the bedrock of our great nation, yet there are those who believe it's an evolving document. You don't build your house on shifting sand, lest it surely crumble. If you want an evolving Constitution, I suggest you move to Russia, where Putin just dissolved theirs and writing a new one. You govern by the consent of the governed, not by your will alone, and you've all betrayed that trust last winter when you refused to even have a conversation with us. Your indifference and actions in public were rude and out of bounds. You owe the city an apology. We're not going to be ignored anymore, nor will we be ostracized, marginalized, or demonized simply because we disagree with you. The Constitution begins with we the people, not we the elect, least you forget. The right to bear arms is a political right designed to safeguard freedoms so that no government entity, including council, can take away those rights. In 2019 and 2020, 147 cities, towns, and councils passed Second Amendment sanctuary city resolutions, almost 97% of the physical landmass of the Commonwealth. Virginians don't want to be turned into felons because they don't understand the law. These would be ultra vires act and not any law at all. Since the mid-1990s, campaign spending has doubled and then doubled again, with massive amounts of money coming into from out-of-state liberals like Mike Bloomberg. As New York Mayor, Bloomberg sued six Virginia gun dealers in 2019. His gun control group spent $2.5 million in 22 state races in Virginia. Over the past decade, Bloomberg has poured more than $10 million into liberal coffers. So make no mistake, Virginia is bought and paid for out-of-state liberals. Over $68 million were spent statewide on the Senate in 2019 alone. We need Virginians deciding who our leaders will be. Virginia values with the Virginian monies, not outside entities buying up of the political bandwidth. We've seen some very disturbing bills come our way. On January 20th of this year, 50,000 Second Amendment supporters descended on our state capitol in Richmond to simply exercise their First Amendment rights to protect our Second Amendment. It was a cold, beautiful day and completely peaceful. Yet the media portrayed us as a violent uprising coming to assault our legislature. It could be the farthest thing from the truth. Yet in August, anarchists and nihilists took over control of peaceful protests across the country with massive rioting and looting. At the same time, defund the police movement started to gain momentum. We were and still are peaceful and wish to remain that way. We aren't advocating insurrection or violence in any form. We want to protect our homes, business, and our families. We just want to keep the Second Amendment the way it was because it surely protects all our rights, our First, our Fourth, and our 14th. And I truly ask that you would pass our ordinance. I think this is too important of a decision to be left up to A to U. You're all good people, but we all live together. And I represent one-third of the city and have completely been ignored, and it's just not right. I really think you need to present this before the city's voters in Norfolk to pass. And I hope you will sincerely consider it, and I look forward to our next meeting in a couple of weeks. And I hope you all have a very, very blessed Thanksgiving.
You too, Mr. Brown. Philip Van Cleve. Is Mr. Van Cleve with us? Okay. What about Marco Fasilio? Marco Fasilira? What about William Jackson Sr.? So, Mr. Dinmore, did he ever join us? Mr. Andrew Dinmore. What about Mr. Ken Reed? Mr. Josiah Hunter? Mr. Philip Van Cleve? Mr. Marco Fasiliro?
Josiah Hunter here.
Okay.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, sir. Welcome, sir. Mr. Hunter?
I'm sorry. I'm hitting the mute button and it wasn't working.
Okay.
My name is Josiah. Yes, sir. My name is Josiah Hunter. I live at 301 East Randall Avenue in Norfolk. All right. Thank you for hearing me out. I'm going to start off saying I support this ordinance. I strongly support this ordinance, and I'm going to repeat my history and why. In 2003, I was violently assaulted in the city of Norfolk. I had to use a firearm to defend myself and my fiance, now wife at the time. I support this ordinance simply because I saw what you guys pushed forward at the end of August. And at the end of August, you pushed forward an ordinance that was later repealed after lots of concern and public outrage. But there were people on this council that put forward an ordinance that if that had occurred, if that ordinance had been in place when the attack occurred on me in 2003, I lived, let's say, on Berkeley Extension across from Berkeley Park. After I was done defending myself, the police then could charge me with violation of an ordinance because I was adjacent from a park. What you proposed was to ban firearms and ammunition and components in city-owned buildings, city-leased buildings, city parks, permitted events, and streets and sidewalks and byways, the public areas adjacent to those areas. So essentially, we're not only going to violate the Second Amendment rights of your citizens and the basic intrinsic human right to self-defense, but also create entrapment zones for law-abiding citizens. There is no provision in there whatsoever to exempt concealed handgun permit holders. So I absolutely support this ordinance in that, quite frankly, we don't have a problem with legal gun owners committing a lot of crimes in Norfolk. We do have a problem with people being able to defend themselves. Just to give you some numbers, as of November 1st, there were 681,187 concealed carry permits in the state of Virginia. That's roughly 11% of the adult population in the entire state. Norfolk has 26,300 of them. That's about 13% of adults in Norfolk. To put that in perspective, there's 27,800 veterans in the city of Norfolk, census reporting. So you had 90,213 ballots cast. So concealed handgun holders alone equal about 28% of the active electorate. So you're talking about 25, and then you talk about gun owners, concealed handgun permits, people are probably only about 10 to 15% of gun owners. So you're talking about thousands and thousands of people that you're going to, that you would then have the ability to restrict. And we simply want the citizens of North to say whether or not we should have, give that power to the city council. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Hunter. I want to call the names once again. I want to make sure we give everyone who signed up an opportunity to speak. This is the last time we'll go through. Mr. Andrew Dinmore, Mr. Ken Reed, Mr. Philip Van Cleve, Mr. Marco Fasiliro, or Mr. William Jackson Sr.
William Jackson Sr. is here.
Yes, sir. Mr. Jackson, welcome to the council meeting.
Thank you. Good evening, Mayor Alexander, members of the City Council. My name is William D. Jackson Sr. I live on Buckingham Street in the Estabrook section of Norfolk. I'd like to ask each of you, and in particular, Angela and Mamie, because you are my Super 7 and Ward 3 representatives on the City Council. I'd like to ask each of you in my strongest terms to support adopting the ordinance proposed to you by the committee petitioners for the Norfolk Second Amendment Preservation Coalition. Am I still on?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Mr.
Oh, I can't see you but on my TV, but anyway, can any of you people tell me when the last time somebody was injured in a city of Norfolk building, park, or ever in the last 3 years? Tell me how many. Any of you? I thought not. So why are you so bound to determine to pass these anti-gun laws? And I'm done.
Thank you, Mr. Jackson. Okay, Mr. Bull, do you have names of other persons who did not wish to speak but wanted to be acknowledged as proponents?
Yes,
please call their names.
Yes, sir. Shirley Stark, Gary Campbell, Jeff Mann, Sherry Lovett, Commander P.A. Dyer, Bobby Baker, Mark Jordan, Anthony Yonta, Carl Barber, Jonathan Montanaro, Ken Blanks, Stephen Grantham, Roberta Hulsberger, Philip Savage, John Lee, Mike Stumpo, Charlotte Ainge, Debbie Meisel, Jay Russell, Gary Gillis, Glenn White, Mike McCacken, William Hulsberger, James Boyles, Mark Davis, Andrew Shiflett, Rick Brown, Charlie Hogue, James and Marilyn Winsett, Darren Bachman, Tim Cullen, Gary Ma, Gene Gill Mash, David Robinette, Debbie Kaufman, Tony Graves, Joseph Cote, Anthony Wheeler, Doug Hinchin. And we have two opponents, sir, to this proposed ordinance, and that is Mr. Ted Warren and Ms. Arlene Iyer. And we have two gentlemen that Mr. Chuck Flowers and Mr. Mike McKenna that asked council to consider exemptions if moving forward for retired law enforcement officers to be able to carry guns.
Thank you. Is there any other business to come before the council, Mr. Manager?
Nothing. So the motion is to continue this public hearing to hear comments to December the 8th. Mrs. Doyle?
So to be clear, that's just a motion to continue to the next public hearing, not to take action on it, correct?
Exactly.
Okay. Aye.
Mrs. Graves?
Aye.
Mrs. Johnson?
Aye.
Mrs. McClellan?
Aye.
Mr. Riddick?
Aye.
Mr. Smeagol?
Aye.
Mr. Thomas?
Aye.
Dr. Alexander?
Before I vote aye, I want to make sure that those who are watching or listening, that the motion to continue is required. We are required to have at least two public hearings, and so we are scheduling the next meeting to meet our requirement. So I want to make sure that everyone is clear the reason that this is being continued, so that we can fulfill our obligation of having at least two hearings on this matter.
That's all I have, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.